Fire Emblem? Oh no. Okay. I was gonna say, I read a leak yesterday that there was gonna be a new Fire Emblem game. And I wanted that leak to be fake, and now I know it might not be real, so maybe we're okay. What's with the performance of these games? They look like they're chugging, man. These Warriors games.
Story set in the same universe as Fire Emblem Three Houses. Let's see the first batch of Nintendo Switch headlines.
The Orange Star Nation needs you. We've got more intel on the Advance Wars 1 plus 2 Reap Bootcamp game. In the first campaign, Advance Wars, you'll advise a colorful cast of commanding officers and use their abilities in vibrant turn-based battles. Each commanding officer is now voiced, bringing even more charm to these characters.
You're gonna get hurt.
I see right through your plans.
Another full campaign awaits in Advance Wars 2 Black Hole Rising. More commanding officers and more diverse terrain can be leveraged for additional tactical opportunities, like blasting through pipelines to cross into enemy territory. In both campaigns, you can fast forward gameplay and reset your turns for a smoother tactical experience. Flex your strategic muscles outside of both campaigns with additional modes. Go for high scores in the War Room. Create and share custom maps in the Design Room. Or battle friends and frenemies in local and online multiplayer. Advance Wars 1 plus 2 Reboot Camp marches onto the Nintendo Switch system.
I never played Advance Wars, actually. What is this shit here? Oh no, not No Man's Sky.
Each orbited by planets teeming with life. Travel to planets.
Fool me once.
In this infinite, procedurally generated universe. Here, you'll discover extraordinary lands and creatures that have never been seen before and may never be seen again. To survive, you must craft your own tools and even your own place to live. In this living and breathing universe, trade convoys travel between stars. Factions vie for territory. Pirates hunt unwary travelers. And the authorities are ever watchful. Your journey may be fraught with danger, and actions have consequences. Traitor, fighter, explorer. How will you live in this universe? Sky lands on Nintendo Switch this summer.
Dude, Mario Strikers is back? Okay. The amount of gear they have to wear to be safe, right? Holy shit. I wonder, is this anything like the one that was canceled? I think there was a canceled Mario Strikers game.
Mario Strikers Battle League.
Battle League, that's a terrible name.
Using tackles, items, and crushing special shots. The main rule in this sport is to rule the field. Try to score more goals than your opponents.
This could end up being fun or very bad, like that horrifically bad Mario Tennis game on the Wii U. This could go either way.
On each team can compete against each other on one Nintendo Switch system. In addition to individual matches, online play will have an online club mode. Join an in-game club and compete for placement in the rankings. Up to 20 players can join a club, so create your own and invite friends and family to play alongside you, or join an existing one owned by other players. Try to become the world's top club. Strikes. Anything goes on this field. Mario Strikers Battle League launches on Nintendo Switch June 10th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
I'll get right on that.
The latest iteration of the Mario Strikers series is coming to Nintendo Switch. We hope you're excited for this anything goes battle soccer game. Next, please have a look at this.
Splatoon. Yep. Man, they really do some weird stuff with this series, don't they? People seem to like it. It's the big thing that came out of the Wii U, really, at the end of the day, was Splatoon. Very gameplay heavy trailer this is, eh? This must be coming out soon. Thank you.
was the trailer for the co-op mode in the Splatoon 3 game, the next wave of Salmon Run. A giant salmonid, one that's never been seen before, was also spotted at the end of the trailer. Will the Inklings and Octolings ink or swim? Splatoon 3 will launch this summer. We hope you'll look forward to future updates.
Can't wait for that to come out so we can stop talking about it.
To more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Bonzer's at the ready. Front mission? Why is Front Mission coming back?
A full remake of the first Front Mission game is storming onto Nintendo Switch.
Wasn't expecting that.
In this
cool
RPG, you'll pilot weaponized machines called Vonzers and lead your battalion to victory. Gain the upper hand in battle by aiming for enemy parts to destroy. Mix and match various weapons and parts to customize your Vonzer.
Looks pretty cool.
Uncover the great storyline.
Oh, they're kind of keeping the old art style, kind of. Okay.
Nintendo Switch this summer. And in the future, the sequel, Front Mission Remake, will also launch on Nintendo Switch.
Okay.
Disney and Pixar Combat Racer.
Oh man. From the creator Disney Kurt
series comes rip-roaring racing action across Disney and Pixar inspired racetracks. Race as a legendary roster of characters on high-speed circuits, using each one's special abilities to battle for victory across the finish line. Choose Mickey Mouse for symphonic speed, Sully for monstrous power, or Mulan for explosive maneuvers. Each racer also possesses powerful ultimate skills, perfect for turning the tables at the last second. Disney Speedstorm is a free-to-play game, with new seasons added regularly, bringing more exciting Disney and Pixar characters, circuits, carts, and more. Plus, enjoy cross-platform play, as well as split-screen and online multiplayer mode. Disney Speedstorm races onto Nintendo Switch this summer.
Kind of a cool name, Speedstorm. I'll give it that.
Dive into these classic franchises on Nintendo Switch.
What does this mean?
Unleash the power of the Force in this classic Star Wars action adventure.
Aw, ew.
Secret apprentice, you'll use devastating Force powers and lightsaber combos as you hunt down Jedi Masters on iconic planets.
This game was so hyped up before it came out.
Repulse, then combine them for even
because of the Wiimote, I think.
Use button controls or opt for motion controls enhanced from the original Wii version.
It would just never end.
You can also duel locally with
the coverage this had back in the day.
Most powerful Jedi. Star Wars The Force Unleashed launches on Nintendo Switch April 20th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
It's amazing how ugly it looks.
The saga of legendary assassin Ezio Auditore da Firenze awaits in three critically acclaimed Assassin's Creed games. Explore Renaissance Italy and 16th century Constantinople. Interact with historical figures and discover secrets of the Creed across three games, two bonus short films, and DLC. Plus, take advantage of enhanced features for the Nintendo Switch system on the go, including touchscreen controls, HD rumble, and optimized on-screen display. Assassin's Creed The Ezio Collection launches on Nintendo Switch February 17th. Pilot mobile suits in dynamic action RPG battles. Strange incidents called breaks are occurring across the Gundam universe. Find out what's causing them and restore the proper timeline. You'll lead three mobile suits in battle. Enhance each suit with parts to improve their power. You can also battle alongside friends in online co-op multiplayer. SD Gundam Battle Alliance launches on Nintendo Switch this year. Two worlds cross in the triumphant
of
this RPG classic.
Uh-oh.
A remaster of the acclaimed RPG Chrono Cross is coming.
I hate this game, but this leaked forever ago. It was in
the protagonist Surge.
It was in the Nvidia leak. Remember that?
Though it somewhat resembles his home world, he finds that he no longer exists here. How did this happen? What is this mysterious another world?
travel back and forth. Ooh, I just saw some crisp there. That's kind of weird. Does this game not actually run better than the original version? Oh my god. A number of improvements have been made to this remaster, like the ability to turn off enemy encounters and a newly enhanced soundtrack. Plus, the frame rate originally released on the Satellaview is included. Experience the origins of Chrono Cross in this text-based adventure. Chrono Cross, the radical dream. Oh, yuck. It still runs bad. That was the key problem with the original release. Is its performance, and it doesn't look any better. What? Wow. Okay, well, we're back to Kirby now. Oh. Oh my god. Nice. Holy shit, it's Kirby Kerr.
It's Kirby's latest unforgettable 3D platforming adventure, Kirby and the Forgotten Land. It all takes place in a mysterious world with an unusual mix of nature and civilization. To rescue the kidnapped Waddle Dees, Kirby sets off on a new adventure. Introducing Mouthful Mode. Inhale a car to zoom around. A vending machine to attack with juice cans. Or become a piercing cone. With mouthful mode, new actions will be available for Kirby depending on the object he inhales. Enjoy exploring with new moves different from copy abilities. Kirby can even weaponize a mouthful of water like this. As Kirby rescues Waddle Dees, Waddle Dee Town will continue to grow and more resources will become available. At Waddle Dee's weapon shop, familiar copy abilities can be evolved. Evolve copy abilities to expand Kirby's range of attacks. They'll also change Kirby's appearance and make him even more powerful. Some copy abilities may have stronger evolved forms. A new adventure awaits our pink puffball. Who are the Beast Pack? What are these enemies trying to do? Can Kirby restore peace to this world? Kirby and the Forgotten Land launches on the Nintendo Switch system March 25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop.
That was Kirby and the Forgotten Land, launching later next month. Please look forward to its release. Let's take a look at some more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Nintendo Direct をご覧の皆さん、 こんにちは。 バッターの大谷翔平です。 ピッチャーの大谷翔平です。 Nintendo Switch 上で今回初めて MLB Show 22が楽しめるようになりました。 それではこちらをご覧ください。
That's right, Otani-san. MLB The Show is coming to Nintendo Switch. That means you can play modes like Road to the Show and Diamond Dynasty on your Nintendo Switch. But that's not all. You can even play Exhibition with a single Joy-Con controller. With cross-progression, you can also earn and use content on any platform where MLB The Show 22 is available. And take your progress on the go with you on Nintendo Switch. Have friends that play MLB The Show 22 online matches on other consoles? No need to worry. You can invite them and play online. I knew you were a true two-way player, but this is ridiculous.
I like that guy. I want to play as him.
You're going to have your hands full of games with these collections. Three Kingdom Hearts collections are almost here. From Kingdom Hearts.
I tried the demo for that, and my internet is not nearly good enough to play. It just doesn't work for me at all.
Adventures alongside Sora, Donald, Goofy, and more for the first time in TV, tabletop, or handheld mode. Kingdom Hearts Integrum Masterpiece for Cloud, containing all three game collections.
Integrum?
Onto Nintendo Switch tomorrow.
What does that mean?
Each collection's cloud version will also be individually available on Nintendo eShop.
Klonoa.
To Nintendo Switch. Across dreamy side-scrolling levels, you'll run, jump, and hover while firing wind bullets to grab and throw enemies. Use each level's surroundings to your advantage. Also, Klonoa 2 is included. Take on these great adventures when Klonoa Fantasy Reverie Series launches on Nintendo Switch July 8th. We're so glad you're here.
Oh, it's Bortle.
Either way, you're in for a fun treat. In these award-winning games, the portal gun is your key to surviving imprisonment in a mysterious lab. Create portals and warp to other areas to find cake? Still unconfirmed. You can pass and soak in cubes, lasers, and robots with unnerving levels of personality. The sequel adds in local, online, and split-screen multiplayer modes. And that part's no lie. Neither is the sentient robot monitoring your every move when Portal Companion Collection warps onto Nintendo Switch this year.
Portal 2 is a bit of a strange game. Doesn't feel like a Valve game.
Classic comes alive.
What is this? Live Alive. Live Alive is back. That's weird. This is a very strange game, actually.
Previously unreleased outside of Japan, the RPG Live Alive makes its overseas debut. Now
Live Alive. I've been saying Live Alive.
Stories featuring different protagonists. Time periods await. The order in which you tackle them is up to you.
And we're going back to this ugly art style from Octopath Traveler. I never liked it. I never liked the Octopath style. Maybe you do. I don't know.
Twilight of Edo, Japan. A shinobi undertakes an important secret mission. Present day, a martial artist strives to become the strongest there ever was. The near future. A youth with psychic powers takes a stand against evil. The distant future, a newly built robot is swept up in a tragedy in space. What other stories are on the horizon?
You will repay my loyalty in death!
Live Alive launches on Nintendo Switch July 22nd. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
Well, I'm glad it's getting localized, I guess.
Next up is this.
Oh god. What's this? Tennis? Sports? Oh yeah. Ugh. Okay. Alright. Alright, let's go.
Please take a look.
Here are the sports included in the Nintendo Switch sports game. You might recognize these three from past Wii sports games. Rally by gently swinging the Joy-Con controller at the right time.
Are these not Miis? What is this?
Bowling.
Oh my god, are we getting rid of Miis?
Or give it a little curve.
Bruh.
And Chambara. Knock your opponent off the platform while attacking and defending. Plus, three additional sports are joining the lineup. Soccer. Use a gigantic ball to make dynamic plays. In Joy matches with Joy-Con controllers to shoot and perform diving headers. By attaching a Joy-Con controller to the leg strap accessory included with the physical version of the game, you can play shootout mode with intuitive kicking motions.
Oh my god. Okay, alright.
Control your shots left and right while keeping the shuttlecock in the air. Unleash
shuttlecock
shots to gain the upper hand. Finally, volleyball. Use a Joy-Con controller to serve, bump, set, and spike the ball. The game supports local play with family and friends on one Nintendo Switch system, as well as online play across all sports. Play against friends online, or opt for random matchmaking. The more you win, the tougher the players you'll face. Try taking on this challenge.
Where's the Miis, though?
How was that? Since I'm already here, I'd like to show you some gameplay of one of the newly added sports, volleyball.
Mr. Takahashi!
Oh, no. Okay. All right, we're wasting time on this. Okay.
All right. I'll play some volleyball online together with Mr. Koizumi. Do you have your wrist strap ready?
Yes, of course. I've got plenty of space around me as well.
All right. Let's start. We'll be including some live commentary throughout our match.
Oh, we're doing this? Volleyball, a newly added sport in Nintendo Switch Sports. What can we expect today from the Takahashi Koizumi team?
Oh, they have Miis.
It's Koizumi to serve.
Okay, good. So Miis are still here.
We begin with Koizumi serving. How will the opposing team react? Takahashi makes the block. Another one's coming. Koizumi saves it. A setup in the air. Here comes the spike. The other team saves it and fights back. And they score. Takahashi didn't quite get it in time. All right, well, it's okay. It's okay. The game's not over. Now the other team serves. Koizumi receives it. Takahashi sets it up. And Koizumi spikes. But it goes right toward the opponent. Here's another attack. Now's their chance. They get the ball. And with a setup from Koizumi, Takahashi scores. They got a point with that fierce spike.
Woo! Let's stop our match here.
After all, we were in the middle of a presentation. All right, I'll be leaving now.
That was an introduction to Nintendo.
I think they knew people didn't want to see that, so they tried to make it fast.
The game launches April 29th. We're planning a free update in the summer that allows you to play soccer matches with a Joy-Con controller and the leg strap accessory. You can use the accessory to play shootout mode at launch. In addition, we're also planning a second free update this fall that lets you enjoy golf.
Oh, golf.
And now, a request to everyone. To help ensure that you can all enjoy playing online, we'll be having an online playtest before the game launches to evaluate various technical aspects. We'd definitely like to ask for your help with this. The online playtest will only be available for players with an active Nintendo Switch Online membership on the dates shown on screen.
Oh, I'm so in.
Please visit the official.
Oh, dude, I'm there, buddy. I'm there.
Switch Sports.
Oh.
I hope you're looking forward to this game.
Thank God. I thought he was going to say that's all I have for now. Okay, we're still going. We're still going.
Get those Taiko drumming skills ready.
Okay. Whatever.
The latest Taiko no Tatsujin game is coming to the Nintendo Switch system. Set in Omiko City, the sacred town for Taiko drums, you'll strive to become a Taiko master along with brand new character Kumo-kun. Drum to dozens of boppin' beats, including Megalovania, Gurenge, Feel Special, and Racing into the Night. And that's not all. An orchestral version of the main theme from The Legend of Zelda is included. That's 76 songs total. Plus,
Take advantage of a practice mode to replay sections of songs as many times as you'd like. New modes have also been added for everyone to enjoy. Put on a live concert with up to four players in Donchan Band. Or face off against each other in Great Drum Toy War. Drum to your heart's content when Taiko no Tatsujin Rhythm Festival launches on Nintendo Switch this year. Plus, a paid in-game subscription service that gives you access to over 500 songs will be available at launch. What's new with these Nintendo Switch games? The brand new tactical RPG game Triangle Strategy is almost here. The protagonist, Sarah Noah, and his allies will be engulfed in the conflict among three nations. Your choices and conviction will determine their fate.
As Lord of House Wolfort, I solemnly swear an oath by which all future lords shall be bound. I will never turn my back on the promise of a better world.
A new demo playable to the end of Chapter 3 will be available on Nintendo eShop later today. Save data from the demo can be transferred to the full game once purchased.
What a great name, Triangle Strategy.
Action awaits in the paid DLC, Cuphead, the Delicious Last Course. Here, you'll explore a brand new Inkwell Isle. Defeat a bevy of new bosses with wild personalities and even wilder attacks. The clever Miss Chalice is a new playable character. Take down fearsome foes with her double jumps, rolling dodges, and more. Cuphead, the Delicious Last Course, wallops its way onto Nintendo Switch June 30th. A free update is coming to the Metroid Dread game. All it takes is one hit. Even from this.
Whoa.
Getting hit even what? Once causes a game over in the brutal Dread Mode difficulty. Can you face this new challenge? And for players new to the Metroid series, take advantage of increased recovery with the newly added Rookie Mode difficulty.
Okay, that's fair.
This free update launches later today. A second free update in April will add a boss rush mode, in which you'll battle bosses continuously, one at a time. Something's bound for Nintendo Switch.
I hope so. Earthbound. Finally. Are we going to get Earthbound Zero, though? Or Beginnings? Whatever they call it. Oh, okay, here we go. Yeah. It's question mark face, look. Mother 3, maybe? Oh, later today. All right. I get to play the old games because the new games are garbage. We get to play the old games, guys. That kind of looks cool.
Mm-hmm.
Lego Bros? Lego Smash Brothers, eh? Okay.
What did you think? Here's some news for Mario Kart fans. Many of you have been enjoying the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe game since its launch in 2017. So, we've been working on remastering select courses from across the Mario Kart series, and we'll be releasing them as paid downloadable content. Please take a look at this trailer.
Oh, okay.
Courses will be coming to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. This is the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Booster Course Pass. You may recognize some courses from past Mario Kart games. Eight courses will be released at a time over six waves. That's
holy shit. How many courses can you get in this game?
Courses such as Coconut Mall, Choco Mountain.
Oh my god, there's gonna be like 10,000 courses in this game.
And Tokyo Blur will be included in the first wave. Of course, you can play these courses locally and online. The first wave of the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Booster Course Pass will launch March 18th.
A little expensive.
On Nintendo eShop. You can enjoy this DLC at no additional cost with a Nintendo Switch Online Plus Expansion Pack membership. Or purchase the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Booster Course Pass on its own.
How was that? I hope you're looking forward to the additional courses in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. This next segment will be our last announcement. Please take a look.
It's either Metroid or Zelda. Xenoblade. It's Xenoblade 3.
Fighting in order to live.
Eh.
And living to fight. That's the way of our world. Ionios.
Tell me, what would possess you to side with them?
We're fighting because there are enemies to kill.
I refuse to believe you're him.
I knew it. I saw this coming.
You're not enemies now.
Fine for you, isn't it? All that time you've got.
You could try to move forwards again.
They're not your friends anymore.
I kind of want to go back to Chronicles X.
Sword March. Man pierced by a great sword. It's the only way you're going to defeat the real enemy.
Whatever life is lost, I won't let you shoulder it all alone.
What good filling up these flickering clocks in our eyes? It'll never replace the friends we've lost.
The flame clock, it has to go.
Ouroboros abhor this world. They must be erased without a trace.
Well, they finally announced it. I was hoping for Metroid Prime 4, but whatever. Metroid Prime 4 is still a no-show, years and years and years and years and years later.
The story of Xenoblade Chronicles 3 ties together the futures of the worlds depicted in Xenoblade Chronicles and Xenoblade Chronicles 2, and it will launch this September. I hope you'll look forward to it. That's all for today's Nintendo Direct. Thank you for watching.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Well, that was a Nintendo Direct. I like the fact that we're getting Earthbound and Front Mission. In fact, all the things I'm excited for are just old games. Is that sad? Well, I'd say it's better than average for a Direct. Maybe I'm going 7.5. Would I like to see Metroid Prime 4? Maybe Breath of the Wild 2. Mario Kart 8 DLC courses, that's a nice surprise. It may get me to actually double dip on that game, because I did play the Wii U version and got all the DLC for that, so maybe I'll go get Deluxe. As if that game needs any more sales. Alright, see you guys next time.